Hi, I'm Valentina V, and welcome to 4-Minute Film School. Today we are talking about upstage lighting. What is it? How do you use it? Let's go. Today we've got cinematographer Chetco Timmins in the house. Hey, Chetco.
Hello.
Chetco, what kind of stuff do you normally shoot?
Yeah, so I shoot music videos and short films and also some tabletop commercials.
Definitely hit him up for that. But today we are doing what?
We are shooting a spec commercial for Yankee Candle.
So Chetco, these lighting setups employ upstage lighting. What does that mean?
So upstage lighting is when you have the light behind the subject in relation to the camera. It's a reference to theater where if someone came in upstage, it was from behind because the stage was slanted. I think of it in a setup called the three-quarter lighting setup. Three quarters of the circle around the subject is the light, so it's 90 degrees away from the camera. Then the subject is looking right down the middle of that angle, and that creates a really nice far side key on the subject and contrast on the other side of the face.
And in what sorts of situations would we want to use upstage lighting?
Upstage lighting, I think, just creates a very cool looking visual. It produces a lot of contrast, foreground to background. It often produces a lot of silhouetting, which I think is visually interesting.
So tell us a little bit about this shoot. What were you shooting?
So I've gotten really into candles during quarantine, and I just wanted to make a little commercial for them. So for this episode, we're shooting a fake commercial for Yankee Candles, all using upstage lighting techniques.
Usually films are shot out of order, and that is certainly true for commercials as well. In this case, you did shoot out of order. What influenced what order you shot in?
For this shoot, the light and the time of day mattered a lot. When I think of shooting a commercial, I want to start with a wide shot to kind of establish the character, the environment, and then get closer as the ad goes on, introduce the product. I knew I wanted to wait for the sun to set for that wide shot, which is what I would have preferred to start with. The next shot in the sequence was gonna be her coming through the front door, so we just decided to start with that shot instead. So for the lighting for this first shot, I started with this window that was already part of the set. It was a frosted glass window right next to the door. I knew I wanted that to be the light source as she comes in. Now she's facing the wall and there's a light behind her that's lighting the far side of her face upstage. There wasn't enough natural light coming through the window, so we put a 300X outside at full daylight, 5600 Kelvin, with a light dome 2, and put it at 100%, and it just directs the light pointed right through the window.
And honestly, since it's meant to mimic sunlight, sunlight is hard light anyway, so you didn't really need that double diffusion. While you were waiting for the sun to get lower in the sky outside, you decided to just keep it going, go into the kitchen for your hero shot. How did you think about that?
Yeah, so the second shot was the third shot in the sequence of her coming in lighting a candle. So I knew we wanted some depth, so I shot into the kitchen. Then I knew we wanted upstage lighting. I had the subject look off camera left into the open space of the room, and then there's a window that we can use to motivate a key light. But first we need to block off a lot of the ambient light, and because it's such a big room and there's skylights, we needed to really get in some negative fill there. There's a skylight almost directly above her, so we brought a 4x floppy tabletopped with one side flopped down up close to the skylight, and it was blocking a lot of the light, but it wasn't creating the level on the face that I wanted. So we brought that really close, and we ended up making a kind of a box around the subject with the one floppy over the top of her, and then another floppy just straight up and down on camera right. Bringing those in really close helped bring down the level on her so we could work with the lighting around her.
I noticed that there was a light that you placed outside of the room that was shining through the window. Why did you do that?
There is a window on the far end of the kitchen that we're not gonna see, so I put a 300X with a light dome too with the diffusion outside of that window. It's nice having it outside of the window instead of inside the window, even though we don't see it, because one of the walls in the kitchen is tile and it's gonna reflect the shape of that light dome in the tile. Having it outside of the window, you still get a reflection, but now it's a window-shaped reflection. And I put that there to match the light spill on the left side of the subject to kind of create contrast between her dark shoulder and the kitchen. So I dialed it to 4100 Kelvin using Sidus Link in order to balance with the daylight coming in. As far as like popping subjects out from the background, a lot of people think you need to shoot a light at them in order to get that edge light to pop them out. But if you just keep the subject dark and the background bright, or vice versa, subject bright, background dark, you're gonna get great separation that way.
You also had another light playing in the scene as sort of an augment to the window light, right?
Yeah, so on the opposite side for her key light, I used a Nova panel, P300C, because I knew I could dial it to the same color temperature that I had for the 300X outside. And that went off camera left, and we just aimed it straight at her and put up a frame. It's actually the DIY frame we made a couple episodes back using as a diffusion frame. And that just softens the light, but doesn't fill in her face too much.
I love that DIY frame. We also used it in the Lighting for Reflections episode, and it really came in clutch. And of course, the product that you're selling is the candle, which actually gets lit mid-shot.
When she brings the candle up and lights it, that produces a little bit more light on her face. What I liked about this shot is even though the level is down, you can still tell it's a daylight shot, but it still feels like cozy and warm and dark without it looking like it's nighttime.
And it really does point to the candle as being the star in the shot. Next, the sun was finally in the place you wanted for that establishing shot.
Exactly, yeah. So then we went outside and got the exterior shot real quick. At that point, the light was in the perfect place. We went around to the side of the house and shot from the side of her getting out of the car and walking through the front gate. And the sun, you want it to be just outside of frame. If you can, block it with some part of the architecture. There was like a wall coming off of the house. So the point source is blocked, but the light hits the subject beneath that. So when she walks up, there's just a great accent on the side of her face. Really brings your eyes to the subject and pops her out from the darker frame.
Why is it important to block the actual sun from being in the frame?
When you have a bright light source in your frame, it's gonna wash out the image because it's shooting light directly into the lens. The sun is creating shadows on the ground. If you just hide the camera in one of those shadows, you're gonna block a lot of that direct sun into the lens, but you're still gonna get the contrast of the scene shooting towards the sun.
You also have to think about this in a commercial setting. It's a little bit simpler because you do have such a short shot. If you're doing this for a conversation, for a narrative piece, the sun moves. So watch out. Lastly, you went inside for the money shot, the shot of the actual product, and there was a little trick in there with the reflection from a mirror.
For the last shot, we have kind of like a product shot that you see at the end of commercials. The rule that I usually go by is product in the foreground and then out of focus background with some sort of action that connects to the commercial. So we have, she places the candle on the table and then walks and starts decorating her Christmas tree. There's also a big mirror leaning against the wall, and that ended up helping us a lot because we're shooting right towards the back window. By now the sun's down, it's almost blue hour, so you get kind of a blue color contrast, and that was reflected in the mirror, as well as the Christmas tree, which has all those beautiful bokehs. That's also reflected, so it creates kind of a salt and pepper effect in the background of light, dark, light, dark.
So you had the blue hour coming from the window, you had the Christmas lights. What about the lights on the candle?
So we wanted to keep with the theme of upstage lighting. We put a Nova upstage off of camera right, pointed back, kind of an edge light with that same diffusion frame right off camera. Now the product is treated like a subject's face where you have an edge light on both sides and darker in the middle to create contrast even on that product. We did bring in a negative fill off camera left to reduce any spill from the kitchen area.
On the left side of the product, I also noticed a little bit of a sliver of a highlight. What was that?
So that was kind of a happy accident of light bouncing around the room, probably from the Nova bouncing off of the white walls off camera left, just reflecting on the edge of that glass jar to create almost like an edge light if it was a subject, which looked really nice.
Yeah, sometimes stuff like that happens where something you didn't specifically intend looks good, and it's up to you whether or not you want to keep that or not.
We don't make mistakes. We have happy accidents.
And now let's take a look at this whole commercial put together.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to cinematographer Chetco Timmins for being our guest on this episode. I wonder, what other lighting techniques make for great product commercials? Leave it in the comments for a chance to win an Aputure M9 light. That's it for us this week. Tune in next week. We're changing up our format a little bit, and I am super excited about it. So be sure to subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss a beat. Until next time, happy shooting!